Hello and greetings from Iceland. But like in my last update, I have some interesting news today. But not just that, since I just got back from the Reykjanes Peninsula with plenty of gigabytes of fresh footage that will be very useful now and in future. But more about my long journey later on in the video. And let's start with a comment from one of our experts since last Monday. So, here is my good old map again, and we just learned that there is a magma intrusion at 16 km depth in the area west of Mount Faradalsfjall, where the Geldingadalir eruption took place in 2021. And I'm glad to get this finally confirmed, since I have been mentioning the earthquakes there every now and then, or ever since the magma intrusion that occurred in December stopped around here. And we are indeed looking at a whole new scenario in the making, only a few kilometers away from the Geldingadalir volcano. So I happened to place myself with a drone around here last weekend, and this is spring in Iceland. And I'm overlooking the region where we have the magma intrusion deep down. We didn't get it mapped from our expert this time, but it's here where the ground has been shaking lately. And we do also see strong earthquake activity by this volcano ridge up there. And you can see Mount Keilir here as well. And as you might have noticed, this is the youngest part of Iceland, a land in the making. And many of the earthquakes are actually taking place under Lake Kleifarvatn now. And that's an unusual location, but I'm linking to one of my older videos about it with drone shots from last year. And as we move on toward Lake Kleifarvatn, we can see those two old explosion craters telling us that we are for sure over one of the hottest spots on the peninsula. So I used the chance also to fly over one of the hot springs between the craters and the lake. It's no road up there, and the peninsula is always showing me something new. And I'm only showing you short clips now, but it's way more to come. I promise you that. But overall, to make this simple now, it was a magma intrusion that originated under Mount Keilir that led to the Geldingadalir eruption. After a journey through a dike, as we could notice on the seismometers back then. And the same thing occurred last December, but faded out. And then we started to see the earthquake activity move toward the Krýsuvík volcanic system. But it wasn't until now that we got it confirmed as a magma intrusion. We were told for a while that the earthquakes there were the result of changes in tension in the region due to the Geldingadalir eruption. But we know it now. It's the red stuff again. So I have something more to work with. And what makes this so interesting is that the ongoing magma intrusion takes place under the so-called Krýsuvík volcanic system. And Mount Faradalsfjall, where the 2021 eruption occurred, is considered to be a separate volcanic system by most experts. And as I take a look at the earthquakes since January 1st this year, we have Mount Keilir here, and there are still movements in the dike between Mount Keilir and Geldingadalir, also between Mount Keilir and the Krýsuvík volcanic system and Lake Kleifarvatn. So it's no wonder why I'm curious to know if the intrusion under Mount Keilir is also feeding the Krýsuvík system. And again, I'm a bit disappointed over the lack of information, but you heard that one before. And as for the importance of this news, the Krýsuvík system is perhaps the worst one to go off for many reasons. The first one is the fact that its fissure swarm stretches all the way into our capital, but we can see it here in the background from this shot. And I am of course curious to know if the Krýsuvík system and Mount Faradalsfjall is after all the same system. But there are many misleading information out there when it comes to the number of volcanic systems on the peninsula. I discovered that when I was making this map a while ago. But that's not the big issue now. The big question has to be, for us Icelanders and tourists on the way, is an eruption imminent in this huge volcanic system? But the short answer is no. The magma intrusion is currently similar in size as the intrusion that led to the Geldingadalir eruption. And furthermore, It's still at 16 kilometers depth, or more or less the same situation as the months before the Geldingadalir eruption. And the experts stated that the magma can accumulate there in huge quantity during a long time period, so there is no reason to change your travel plans. And first, we would get thousands of earthquakes and plenty of other warnings, like last year. And it's also highly unlikely to see an eruption take place just by our doorsteps in Reykjavik. And judging from history, eruptions on the peninsula are mostly tourist eruptions, if you know what I mean. And the good news is that we are dealing with the westernmost part of the system now, so lava from there would most likely find its way down to the ocean by the south coast or somewhere around here, where we only have endless lava fields overlapping each other. So there is no reason to be worried about this location, but if an eruption occurs on the north side of this mountain range, then we have the airport road at risk. But that road looks like this, where it's bypassing an old lava field from the same volcanic system. But it's still too early to go deep into this. And the biggest question is, for how long will this magma chamber hold until something gives in? All we need is a strong earthquake and the timer is on. And the unfolding scenario looks more and more like the months before the Geldingadalir eruption. And then we might just as well get an eruption elsewhere on the peninsula first, since this is the earthquake graph from the complete peninsula since January 1st, or 5,400 earthquakes in total. And we have like 4-5 places that look active enough at this moment to be considered as the next location for an eruption, but the Krýsuvík area is the most likely system to go off next, as things look today. And it's not a surprise that I've been trying to prepare my channel for a while now for whatever Mother Earth might throw at us during this next chapter. So back to my long trip, but I managed to fly with my drone over all the necessary locations on the peninsula as I finally got back from the west fjords of Iceland. But I have to tell you a little story from there. But I had a photo assignment there in a fish factory, and it took me 2 days longer than I expected because they didn't have the type of fish they needed to show off one of their fancy machines that was to be a part of the photoshoot. But the people in the West Fjords of Iceland are just so nice and relaxed and offered me an apartment. So I decided to use some time to move around, wait for fresh fish, and it did pay off since I was able to capture lots of spring footage that will be very useful for long 4K videos with relaxing music that I'm making. But I've been planning to make such videos for a long time, and the first one will be online after this summer. I did also shoot footage for my series about Icelandic road tunnels, but notice how much snow they still got on the West Fjords all the way down to the coastline. At the same time, or when I left North Iceland, it looked like this. All the snow was gone on the lowlands, and then I took off from the Westfjords using some of the worst roads in Iceland, where we still lack road tunnels, and drove directly to the south coast, where I experienced the third season version of Icelandic spring in less than a week on our small island. But everything was turning green in Grindavík, where I got excellent light for a while. But I didn't get good light all the time, of course, but it was always good enough to make stories about each and every destination I visited this time. And I could for the first time take a good look at the Eldvörp craters near Grindavík and also the Sundahnjúkar craters. And I did also fly by the plate boundaries where they rise up from the seabed and some other places that I drove by during this long trip. And I learned so much from the tour, and first of all that I'm not equipped as well as I wished for. But as soon as I lift up the drone, the countdown timer is on. So I need more batteries and chargers, and actually a car that I can use as an office as well, or where I can do some editing work on the road and keep my channel alive while I'm out chasing the light. So there are a lot of things on my mind about that, but more about that later. I got more and less all the shots I needed to cover whatever might happen next on the peninsula. And during the last day, it started to rain, and as I was heading back north, it was snowing. But it was a great tour, even though I'm still a bit tired, and many of my upcoming videos will be about the specific volcanic systems and rift zones on the peninsula, or mini documentaries that are more and less timeless, since my news related content has a very short lifespan. So short documentaries covering rows of craters, volcanic systems, and overall the plate boundaries to support my news-related content or to link to when things are moving fast. And then, in some cases, I might be showing you the last videos from a landscape that simply won't be there in a few months or years, or buried under lava like Geldingadalir are now. And I wish I had drone footage from there since before the eruption last year. But this is how Geldingadalir look today, with the Krýsuvík volcanic system in the background, where the action is now. And we are straight over the spot where the magma intrusion from last December stopped. And we might just as well see a whole new story develop tomorrow. We just can't predict the future. But we can prepare, and that's what I'm doing on my channel. For me, it's all about to have footage that covers the complete peninsula. And I took a large step into that direction last weekend. So, if you are not a subscriber, please consider clicking on the subscribe button for my upcoming work. And my channel is not just about our volcanoes. It will, by time, become one of the largest sources of video information about my home country. And of course, not the ordinary tourist channel. It's the channel that tells it all and shows it all. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.